The word of God was very rare. Second thing, there was no open vision. There's no prophetic vision. The third thing, and it came to pass at that time when Eli was laid down in his place and his eyes began to wax dim that he could not see. The third thing is the high priest was turning blind or was becoming blind. The high priest's eyes were becoming dim. The high priest could not see. This is what is happening today in the churches, in the body of Christ. Leaders are becoming blind, spiritually blind. They cannot see. Right in front of them, evil things are happening. They can't discern. They cannot see. I tell it this way. The father's eyes are becoming dim. That means father lost spiritual discernment. And the sons don't know the Lord. This is what happened in Eli's time. Eli is becoming blind. His eyes are weak. And his sons don't know the Lord. Imagine what will happen to that congregation. What will happen to that church? Do you want to know how blind Eli had become? Eli, the high priest, had become so blind that when Hannah was crying and praying in the spirit, he mistook her to be speaking some rubbish in flesh. And he says, "You are drunk and you are just talking and talking." Because Eli was out of touch with God, with what God was doing in the spirit, he mistook the spirit's work to be the work of the flesh. Today, the leadership of the church have been out of touch with what God is doing now, so they are mistaking what the devil is doing to be that of God. It is evil spirit that is working, and they are saying this is the spirit of God that is working. All false is happening, and they say this is supernatural, this is God's work. They are out of touch with God's present time plan. So they lost their vision, lost their discerning. Eli, spirit's work, he mistook it for flesh. But today, people are mistaking flesh work to be spirit's work. It's done in the flesh, but they're saying, Holy Spirit did it. It's done by evil spirit, but they're saying, oh, God is moving. Because they lost discerning. One of the strategies of the enemy is, the moment he gets hold of you, he will rob your vision. Tell me what happened to Samson when Samson was caught and his head was shaved. What did the Philistines do? The first thing they did was put out his eyes. So you lose your spiritual sight, you lose your spiritual vision, you lose spiritual discerning. You can't discern. Lot of people in the leadership have lost spiritual vision because the enemy trapped them and removed their spiritual eyesight. Judges 16, 20, 21, 22. There are two verses there. One saddest verse and one happiest verse. Delilah says, Samson, the Philistines have come. He got up. He said, I will go as usual. I'll shake myself. But he didn't know the Lord had departed from him. One of the saddest verses. The Philistines took him, and first thing they did was took out his eyes, brought him to Gaza, and the Philistines bound him with fetters of brass, and he did grind in the prison house. But then there's a good news. What is the good news? How be it, the hair of his head began to grow again after he was shaved. What mercy of God. The Bible says, his hair began to grow once again. The hair of his head began to grow. Wow. I want to tell you today, you might have made a mistake. You might have got into trouble. You might have got into bondage, lost your sight, lost everything, lost the anointing. But time will come. Once again, you will grow. The hair of Samson grew again. Once again, you'll grow. God is a God of second chance. God is a God of third chance. God is a God of fourth chance. God is a God of fifth chance. God is a God of 100 chance. God is a God of 1,000 chance. God is a God of 10,000 chance. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you. If you only repent, if you only turn to God. Samson realized his mistake. He turned to God. He said, God, hear me once. Hear me once. Let my strength come back that I may take revenge of all these people. Strengthen me one more time, O God. God heard his prayer and strengthened him. And you know how he pulled down those two pillars that were holding the entire house. And there were more people who died that day than all that Samson killed other times. Once again, the hair of Samson grew. If you have lost the anointing, once again the anointing will come back. If you lost prayer life, once again prayer life will come back. If you lost holiness, once again holiness will come back. You lost strength, once again strength will come back. My word to you is, get right with God. Come back to God and start seeking the face of God. These messages are not to condemn you, but these messages are to bring you back to Jesus Christ. Get back on the track. Come back to Jesus. Don't become arrogant and adamant saying, okay, I lost all these things. All these people are speaking against me. No, God loves you. That's why he's speaking to you. Once again, the anointing will come upon your life. This message is for the universal church of Jesus Christ. When it is spoken from here, it is spoken in the spirit realm to the entire body of Christ all over the world. These are the words of God. God speaking. Not just limited to this little crowd. God is saying something to the universal body, and he's speaking. Get back to God. Get back to